media for a while. I don't know if I'm gonna come back at all.
Hey guys, I have to say.
Okay, I'm not okay.
I'm 100% going to have to jump off a bridge. So I go down to Walmart. I'm in a sketchy town, and I have to make a phone call real quick before I go in. So I get on the phone, and this couple walks by me. Sketchier looking couple, let's just be honest. And the guy turns around and looks at me and goes, threesome? And I've not had a good day. I've not had a good day. I'm instantly infuriated. I mid-sentence hang up the phone call and go, are you fucking kidding me? And he looks at me, and the lady also turns around and looks at me so confused and goes, what? And I'm like, did you just say threesome? And the guy looks at me for a minute, and then his face, like, he understands and goes, I thought you were Teresa. He was really genuine. He really thought I was Teresa. This man was not trying to solicit me. They were so nice about it, but oh my god, I'm 100% going to have to jump off a bridge. So I go down to Walmart. I'm in a sketchy town, and I have to make a phone call real quick before I go in. So I get on the phone, and this couple walks by me. Sketchier looking couple, let's just be honest.
In December of 2014, 19-year-old Jessica Chambers was essentially horrifically burnt alive. A passing motorist saw Jessica stumbling through a ditch and called 911, and when first responders arrived, they found Jessica burning beside her vehicle. She was still alive at the time, and she was actually running towards them wearing only her underwear. They were able to ask her who had done this to her, and she was able to spit out one word before losing consciousness, and that word was either Eric or Derek. The first responders weren't able to make out exactly what she said, but she was airlifted to hospital, and she had had gasoline poured down her throat and all over her body and was essentially lit on fire. And unfortunately, the next day, she died of her injuries. So what happened to poor Jessica? In December of 2014, 19-year-old Jessica Chambers was essentially horrifically burnt alive. A passing motorist saw Jessica stumbling through a ditch and called 911.
That's harsh.
So earlier that day, before this tragedy had happened, she hung out with a couple of friends in the morning, and then she went home to have an afternoon nap. And her mom says after she woke up from her afternoon nap, she did get a text message from someone, and she didn't know who it was, but Jessica also just said that she was going to go grab a bite to eat and clean out her vehicle. And when she was at the gas station cleaning out her vehicle, that is actually the last time that anybody ever saw her alive. And they were able to retrieve her phone records, and her phone was found at the crime scene, and it showed that she had driven to an area called Batesville, which she really didn't have any reason to be, that she was found essentially burnt alive. And they also were able to see through her phone records that she was chatting with somebody and going to meet up with a man named Quentin Tellis. So earlier that day, before this tragedy had happened, she hung out with a couple of friends in the morning, and then she went home to have an afternoon nap. And her mom says after she woke up, so this is Quentin Tellis, and this is the person who had last texted Jessica from her phone and the last person that she was in contact with. And looking back at their text messages throughout the last whole month, they had been in basic constant contact, and Quentin had been asking Jessica multiple times to have sex with him, and she declined over and over and over again. And his story also changed many, many times through the investigation. He first had said that he wasn't with her at all that evening, and then he had said that they went to Taco Bell, but their cell phone data had shown that they had traveled to Batesville together at the time that she had gone to Batesville. And then he said his friend had picked him up, and his friend actually said no because he was at a football game that night. So all of the clues were leading to Quentin. So even though Quentin and Jessica had been in constant contact the entire month before, after this had happened, he had never
throwing a party at your penthouse?
Again,
with guest services and the evidence from last
last night's debauchery will be cleaned right away.
Compliments to our winner of a brand new vehicle at the Lucky Wheel.
So even though